Next, take a personal supermarket tour and find out how to fill your grocery cart with healthy food items.
Hi, we're here at a grocery store and we're here today to show you how to make healthy food choices. Now, why is it important to make healthy food choices according to Eat Well with Canada's Food Guide? Because you want to make sure you have enough energy to work, play, or to go to school. You want to make sure you have key nutrients to help reduce your risk of chronic disease, such as diabetes, osteoporosis, heart disease, and some cancers. When you're getting all your nutrients and your energy, it's also going to help you with your concentration and also your moods. You want to make a list before you even go to the grocery store. You don't want to go to the grocery store hungry because you're going to make spontaneous shopping decisions and most likely unhealthy shopping decisions. So on your list, you want to have foods that cover all four food groups. And you also will help you to, when you have that list, help you to keep within your budget. Now, did you know that when you come to the grocery store, that if you stick to the outside of the store, that you're basically covering all four food groups at Canada's Food Guide? So that's your basics. So a good place to start is your fruits and veggies. And the brighter, the better the fruits and veggies. You're gonna get lots of vitamins and minerals, but also a lot of natural health benefits when you choose those dark green, dark orange, dark red type of veggies or fruit. We looked at fruits and veggies. The second food group is grains. Grains are really important. Grains and fruits and veggies is gonna give you that fiber that we recommend. Women need about 25 grams of fiber a day. Men need about up to 35 grams of fiber. Why is fiber important? It's great for your gut to keep your gut healthy. And secondly, it's gonna help you reduce your risk of chronic disease such as heart disease. It does keep your blood sugar levels and it helps to keep your blood cholesterol levels normal. So we wanna look for grains that have the word whole grain. And secondly, we wanna look for grains that on the package it says a minimum of 2 to 3 grams of fiber per serving. The cereal is a good place to start to show you how to read a food label. Basically, there are three pieces to a food label. You've got your ingredient list. Your ingredient list is listed from most to least by weight. The second piece is your nutrition facts box, which includes serving size, calories, and 13 nutrients. The key thing to look at when you're looking at your nutrition facts box is the DV percent, daily value percentage. Basically, your daily value is a scale of 0 to 100. And you know whether or not you have a little or too much of one nutrient depending on that percentage. So this serving size of cereal has 5 grams of fiber. The daily value percentage is 20%. That means for today, if you have this serving size, you're getting 20% of the fiber that you need for today. So this is a good choice. The third piece to your label is your nutrition claim. This particular cereal box states that it's high in fiber. That's a nutrition claim. A nutrition claim is anything that's high or low. It could be high, low fiber, high, low fat, or low sodium would be examples of nutrition claims. And manufacturers cannot put a nutrition claim unless certain criteria are followed. There's also diet/health related claims, and there's only 4 that are allowed. And the 4 relate to heart disease, some cancers, osteoporosis, and high blood pressure. When you look at Canada's Food Guide, it recommends 2 servings of fluid milk from your milk and milk alternatives food group. That's simply because we want to make sure that you're getting all the calcium that you need during the day and also the vitamin D, because without vitamin D you can't absorb the calcium that you're taking in from your dairy products. You want to look for milk fat percent of 2 or less, so 2% or less. As for cheese, block cheese, you want to look for 20% milk fat or less. Now everybody these days is on a no-fat, low-fat bandwagon, which is not bad. However, when you're looking at dairy products, it's not necessarily bad to have a 1% or a 2% milk fat. It actually keeps you fuller longer, as long as it's less than 2% milk fat. So how do you make healthy food choices in your meat section? You basically want to look for lean cuts of meat. Meat that doesn't have a lot of visible fat. If you're looking at pork, you want to look at loin, tenderloin, pork loin. So you want to look for lean cuts of meat. If it's ground beef, it's extra lean. You want to look at serving sizes. When you bring your meat home, watch your serving sizes, because you still are getting saturated fats in your meat and you're getting trans fat naturally occurring. So you want to look at serving sizes, and Canada's Food Guide recommends 75 grams as a serving size. That's basically a deck of cards or the palm of your hands. Let's talk about meat alternatives, something like your beans. Your beans are super healthy. They're not only a great source of protein, they're a great source of fiber, and that soluble fiber, which reduces your risk of chronic disease and keeps your blood sugars and blood cholesterol levels normal. Your beans are super high in fiber. Another meat alternative would be your eggs, and Canada's Food Guide does suggest 2 eggs a day, and also 2 tofu if you're a vegetarian. Fish is in the category of meat and meat alternatives. Canada's Food Guide recommends 2 servings of fish per week. Fish is super healthy for you. It has those nice omega-3s, and omega-3s contribute to great heart health, reduces your risk of heart disease. We're gonna do a little bit of pre-planning, like make ourselves a list, and we're gonna come back to the grocery store, and we're gonna be able to make those healthy food choices according to Canada's Food Guide.